11 Ohio cops charged with violently assaulting people. You got to pay attention. We know it's systemic. We know it's a cultural thing. But this means it's written into the law, it seems like, that this is what we're doing here, and you're not going to do anything about it until it gets so big and so grand that I guess we can't ignore it. Ohio, Cuyahoga County Prosecutor's Office, the Cleveland Division of the FBI, held a news conference Wednesday afternoon. They announced public corruption, civil rights violation indictments against 11 current and former East Cleveland police officers. Let's show you who they are, the players in this. Cuyahoga County Prosecutor Michael O'Malley led the conference, joined by Assistant Prosecuting Attorney Gregory Moosman, FBI Special Agent in Charge Gregory Nelson. There they are before the cameras. Several body cam videos of the individuals who were indicted were shown. First video presented showed Officer Nicholas Fody, who previously resigned. Why was he allowed? Repeatedly stomping on the head of a person in custody. Why? Just had to lean in on that one, Mayor. Okay. I don't want you to comment just yet because I need you to get the full body of work of these alleged perps. Second video shows Officer Ian McInnes, current police detective, ordering a person to lie down on the floor before kicking them in the back. Play that.
On the ground, face down, or you will be tased. Face down on your stomach. On your stomach. On your stomach. Stay down. Put your arms out now. Do not move. Do not move.
Okay, tough guy. There's more. Third video shows Officer Kyle Wood, previously indicted, Sergeant John Hartman, current police sergeant, and Officer Tristan Homan, currently an Elyria police officer after resigning at East Cleveland, because we know what they do, Mayor. They just move on to another jurisdiction. Let's play that.
Get that bitch. Stop.
Hang on.
Get his ass, boy!
Get in
the car.
What
should I say?
Nice little ass whooping.
Shouldn't have resisted.
Having a bad day, so let me take it out on the community. I know what you're thinking, Sharon, that's enough. We've seen enough examples. No, you need to feel and experience street justice, East Cleveland, Ohio style. So the fourth and the fifth videos, well, they involve McInnes again. I'm still not done. Cue up number six. It involves Hartman. Shows him repeatedly striking someone in the head because, you know, it's just another day at the office.
Stand up.
This is your life. Remember that? Remember that, Mayor? I'm going to pause and let you jump in. But remember that show, This Is Your Life? I feel like you could just roll these videos. This is the torment that East Cleveland has been living under. You know, this is my old stomping ground. This is where I cut my teeth as a reporter for many years. And none of this surprises me all these years later, Mayor.
This is indicative of policing black people in America. We can no longer pretend this few bad apple situation is not what we exist in. That city is 88.9% black. And this is how police officers treat these citizens. This is not how you treat humans. The idea that anybody can pretend that this is not the culture, because these videos, these body cam videos existed. No one cared about what was on these cameras until the FBI investigation began. It's not like this just happened. This was over a span of years with 11, some of them in multiple videos, officers that were being promoted for treating people this way. And I know there are tons of complaints that citizens made against these officers. Everyone arrested by any of these officers that is black should be have their cases reopened, because racism is on display every time one of those guys put on a uniform. And it is absolutely disgusting that we saw what we just watched.
It is disgusting. And I have mixed feelings, and we'll get into them, about the prosecutor in this case, who's very bold next to the FBI and has a starring role as he plays video after video. We know the close relationship between police, prosecutors, and discretion. So I'm not buying that there doesn't need to be a wide net cast and some real scrutiny on everyone's role here. What did you overlook? What did you look away from? That's what I want to know. But let's go ahead and cue up the seventh video involving Officer Tyler Munson, current police officer, previously indicted Officer Brian Stoll, currently on leave for previous indictments. Is anybody clean here? Kyle Wood following an arrest and at the ECPD precinct. Take the video.
Nothing.
I didn't see anything either.
How's it still turn on?
That's impressive.
That's his phone.
I got him.
Not anymore.
That was the easiest pursuit you could have ever done. He went in a circle.
Literally,
he kept going in a circle.
I was getting so annoyed. I literally got over the loudspeaker. I was like, this is really getting stupid, dude. Can you please stop the car?
I threw the meanest hook.
I got one. I didn't get a single lick in.
Oh, I get it. You're making a violent TikTok video. You want to be the next Jake Paul, Logan, whichever brother was running away from Floyd Mayweather. Is that what we're doing here? Is that what we're doing? There's still more. Maybe we'll have a bigger dozen. I don't know. Eighth video involves McGinnis, Homan, an officer, Loris Mann, former officer who was terminated. Wow, somebody got fired. Shows a man colliding with the squad car McGinnis was driving. McGinnis calls out over the radio. The man struck his vehicle, but Prosecutor O'Malley said a longer version of the video more clearly reveals. Yep. McGinnis appeared to strike the man instead of avoiding him. Man sustained a broken pelvis from the event. Do you know how painful that is? After the man is on the ground, a struggle occurs and one officer uses a taser on him 3 times while the other 2 officers punch him. Take the video.
He's bleeding from the head, bleeding from the head.
Stop.
Just get
fighting.
Get control. Stop fighting. Hold on, taser out.
Taser, you gotta taser get out.
You want your taser? Stop fighting.
Stop.
Taser out. Drive stun. You want to get it again?
Stop fighting.
Stop fighting. Stop. 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 Stop.
Where did he dump the gun?
Stop resisting. Stop resisting. You're going to get it again. Stop resisting. Stop.
I can close my eyes and I can hear my ancestors and slave catchers, and I can hear them, Mayor. That's what I hear. Thugs. You know, there's people who pay Mayor to go play war games and, you know, get beat up and do all of these things. Their adrenaline's going, and that's a fun time for them. This is real life, and this is what we're paying people to do.
That's the part about it. This is taxpayer money funded lynching. This man had on handcuffs with a broke pelvis and was getting punched, kneed, and they're saying he's resisting. How is he resisting? He's on his belly, handcuffed. He's not resisting. You're on top of him and he's in pain. You hear him groaning throughout the video. The problem we have in this country is America's tolerance for black suffering is so high that we are left to deal with police officers that show up in our community in this manner, treating us as if we're animals. And they are absolutely, historically and now, getting away with lynching black people.
Yeah, because they are.
Yeah, and it's directly, we cannot silo policing from slave catchers. And I'm glad you said that, because the first police departments in this country, actually in North Carolina, were transformed out of slave catchers. So slave catchers became police officers, and they still doing the same thing that they used to do.
And this is why we need
seizing black bodies for torture.
This is why your voice is so important, because this is our history. Why are you trying to repair these? This sometimes you got to tear the house down. You have to tear it down. The car is totaled. God forbid you're in an accident and they come. You put in the claim. We can't. There's nothing we can do with this vehicle, Mayor. It's totaled. Okay, that's what we're doing. And there's still more, okay? Ninth video, yep, number nine. We're doing it deliberately because you need to see, feel, and hear all of it. Officer Brian Parks, current officer, tasing a man multiple times. Let's go.
You guys about to tase me.
Shut up, get up.
Why'd you guys tase me so many times?
Why'd you run?
Why wouldn't you give me your hands?
I gave you my hands.
Get up.
Seven of the officers, newly indicted, four of them, previously indicted on other charges. As of Wednesday, there have been 16 current or former East Cleveland police officers indicted in the last 6.5 months. That from News Channel 5 out of Cleveland. Current East Cleveland Police Chief Brian Gerhardt released a statement on the indictment stating, I'm going to go ahead and read it, Mayor, but it's real tough to get through this statement, this foolishness that I'm about to read, but this is what they provided. There has been full cooperation from the department during the ongoing investigation before promising to move the department in a positive direction and rebuild the agency. Chief, use a lie. A lie. Rebuild the agency? What? Full cooperation? All of this happened when who was in charge? Huh? This isn't the NBA where you're trading players and you're seeking a championship. This is the same old game. Tell me I'm wrong, Mayor.
You're not wrong at all. You're spot on. It's unbelievable. It's unbelievable that this person is not under investigation as well. The fact that you can sit back in your chair as you managed these people, all of these people, you managed all of them as the chief and promoted some of them. And only one of them has been terminated. The rest of them are getting taxpayer money still on leave. And I think this is only in policing, especially in black communities, can this level of behavior be rewarded and this guy be taken serious. This police chief, the DA, everybody in this system, everybody in that system need to be need to be investigated, because it's no way that you lived in this city and you did not know this was happening, especially if you were part of law enforcement. This is a culture, people bragging on cameras about beating citizens, people breaking evidence. That is unbelievable to me, on camera, going back to the station, still bragging about how you beat somebody, is a culture. This is water cooler conversations for them. Mm-hmm. He said that was a good A beating, meaning that you've got punches in before that you didn't think were great. Idea of this happening in a place that used to be considered the trunk line. This was the northern spot that slaves wanted to get to on the Underground Railroad. And now we see there ain't no freedom line in America for black people, because government, agencies of the government, police departments still beat us in 2023 as if we are owned.
It's disgusting. Absolutely disgusting. Last year, we should tell you, 9 East Cleveland police officers, including former police chief Scott Gardner, all indicted on various charges. Their cases are still pending in court. Gardner was initially suspended, placed on administrative leave after he was hit with multiple felonies that included telecommunications fraud, tampering with records, passing bad checks, failing to remit, theft, grand theft, theft in office. Gardner would eventually be terminated from the force. Eventually, Mayor, okay? And for the city council, okay, in East Cleveland, be putting out the pleas. We were desperate here. We barely any cops left on. Gangs, organized gangs are off the street. Okay, they were wearing their colors, which were blue. They all had the same service weapons. The gangs are off the streets temporarily, perhaps, okay? Some remain. What do you mean? Maybe East Cleveland is safer now with less cops. Have I gone too far, Mayor?
Absolutely not. And I mean, it wouldn't be the only city we've seen, right? We saw the same thing in Camden way back when they got rid of their police department because of corruption. Sometimes you just got to start over, completely over, do away with the entire institution of policing, not just in East Cleveland, but everywhere. So I'm 100% with you that we need to rethink policing, especially when it shows up like this.
Gangs are gangs. Hit them with a RICO charge, right? Isn't that what you would do to, okay, hey. I don't know what their gang signs are, Mayor, but I'm sure they have them, okay? This is, and the former chief was a criminal, okay? Those are the allegations.